Oh, sedih. Oh, macam-macam. I'm not saying marah sedih is wrong. Tak. You can. It's how you do it. Siapa yang kadang-kadang rasa marah? Kadang-kadang. Pernah tak orang cakap, uruskan marah anda? Manage your anger? No? Because it won't work anyway. Yeah? So, I'm going to teach you how to manage your patience. Would you want to learn how to manage your patience?
Yes.
Alright. Patient dalam bahasa Melayu apa dia? Dalam bahasa Arab? S-A-B-R. Sabar. Okay, ready? S. Sabar tu is an acronym by itself. Okay, so untuk uruskan sabar, use this acronym as your guideline. First step you do, S, shut up. S stands for what?
Shut up.
No, you kena ada attitude sikit when you say shut up. Pandang kawan sebelah, cakap, shut up. Oh, pusing kat dia. Now, when I say shut up, it means two things. Shut up your mouth and shut up the voices in your head. Remember the inside out people inside there? Yeah, okay. The reason kita pening kepala kerana is all these voices in your head tengah bergaduh sama sendiri. Okay. So how do you shut up the voices in your head? Sleep? No. Your mind doesn't sleep at night. No, it still keeps awake. Pasal tu kita bangun pening lagi. Yeah. Alright, this is it. Orang yang buat yoga, the way they focus on one thing is they will always repeat one word. Contohnya to have inner peace, and they repeat. And what happens? All the voices in the head shut up. Kita ni Allah. Zikir. Allah. 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 Until all the voices in your head shut up. And you shut up until you can say something good about what's happening. Selagi you cannot say anything good about it, shut up. Keep quiet. Okay? So, S, step one. Shut up. A. Acknowledge the situation. Now, how do you acknowledge the situation? Remember, kita belajar, whatever happens, it happened because Allah will it to happen. Yes or no?
Yes.
That's how you acknowledge. Kita sering lupa tu. Orang langgar kita, boom, terus meletak. Ini, oh, boom, Alhamdulillah. You know what I mean? Respond and react. So, acknowledge the situation. Say Alhamdulillah. Things happen. Okay? Whatever happen, anything good or anything bad will happen. Ini namanya takdir. How you respond to how it happens, that's your choice. S, A, B. Break the pattern. Now Rasulullah kata, kalau you marah berdiri, what do you do? Duduk. Kalau masih duduk, masa marah lagi, what do you do?
Baring.
So, you change your state. You change your physical, your mind will change sekali. Okay? Bila saya marah, dulu-dulu, saya cari aiskrim. Dulu-dulu, when I'm like angry gila kan, I'll be cari aiskrim lah. Now, how I eat aiskrim, you know how the degree of marah I am. So, kalau I boleh duduk dekat kursi, dekat table tu makan aiskrim macam ni, marah tu kira okey lagi. Tapi kalau I duduk tepi jalan, mencangkung makan aiskrim, then don't touch me that time. Itu dulu-dulu. How I manage my anger. Okay? Sekarang, I cari tabung. So, contohnya, bila I marah kan, I pergi cari tabung. Kalau KFC kat situ, I pergi lah. Kat kaunter kan ada tabung KFC kat depan. I mula masukkan duit. First shilling first. Shilling. Tengah marah ni. Shilling. Asal masuk RM1, RM5. Masuk 10, dia slow sikit. By the time reach 50, I'm a bit slow. Until I stop. And then I leave. Because I have to let it go. Kita marah. If you keep it, dia makan dalam, betul? So, I let it go. Itu cara saya. Now, some of you, how many of you when you marah, you go and eat atau you go shopping? Put out your hands. Now, here's my suggestion here. If you want to eat, You buy food, but you give it to somebody else. Don't eat it for you. Because if you eat it, bayangkan, eh, kau beli chocolate cake ni, ah, aku tengah marah ni. So that marah goes in. You see what I mean? So that marah tu, you need to go out. You need to let it out. So bagi the chocolate cake. Nah, aku pergi secret recipe ni, nak ambil kau cake. Kenapa kau ni? Aku tengah marah. Makan je lah. How many of you will go shopping? Put your hands. When you're angry, you go shopping. Alright, bayangkan. Aku marah ni. Oh, tengok. Baju merah RM100, beli lah. And every time you see that baju merah in your closet, it will remind you of the day you marah. Yes, ah? Apa gunanya? So nak beli baju merah tu, beli untuk orang. You buy, you give. You have to let it go. You have to break the pattern. Do something else. Okay? Are you following me?
Yes.
SABR. Now, you say redha. Now, redha to me is two things. Redha means to me, you learn from the situation, then you let go. You watch Frozen?
Yeah,
let it go. Don't sing. Do not sing the song. Please. You know how some people say forgive and forget?
Yes.
No such thing.
Yes.
No such thing. Yeah? You forgive and you let go. You cannot forget because everything good, you can remember. You're bound to remember everything bad. The thing is, kenapa Allah let you remember? Yes, as learning. So that's why you need to learn. Learn from the situation. As long as you cannot learn from the situation, you will never redha. You will never can let it go. So learn from the situation. Learn from it, and then let it go. If it comes back, it is because Allah said, you belum habis learning lagi. There's still some learning that you missed out. And you relearn. That's the fastest way to learn. Nabi Musa nak ikut Nabi Khidir. And then, ini dalam Quran, kan? And then Nabi Khidir kata, not yet, kau belum cukup ilmu. Kau belum cukup ilmu. Oleh kerana kau belum cukup ilmu, kau tak akan sabar. Tapi Nabi Musa nak ikut juga. Kan? So, here's the learning, ya. You see, kita nak sabar, kena ada ilmu. The thing is, can we ever have all the ilmu in the world?
No.
So, to reach that point, you need to learn and learn and learn. Whenever anything happens to you, you want to redha, learn from it, then let it go. That's how you redha. Puan Hayu, you there? All right, thank you very much for the experience. When you see me again, senyum apa?
Tiga.
Tepuklah kawan. Now, after the closing that Puan Hayu wants to do,